Commissioner Staples pursues policies that promote job growth and will expand our transportation system, improve consumer protection, and secure our border.
Well, thank you so much. It's great to be back in Irving today. I appreciate the work that each of you do to move our great state forward. Mayor, it's always good to be an Irving council member. Congratulations to you.
As good as we are, as many of the great things that we have to brag about, we have growth challenges. We have question marks on some of those issues that are in the minds of the decision makers on where those dollars are going to be going. And we need to remove the question marks about Texas. And that's what I'm here to visit with you about today. And we have an opportunity to do that when we think about the challenges that we have. The thing that I'm excited about, Proposition 1, is that it's going to build new roads with no new taxes, no new tolls, and no new debt. And that sounds like a winning combination, if you ask me.
Now, Proposition 1, just to give you a quick, brief update on what that really is, y'all all are familiar with the Rainy Day Fund today, right? In the late 1980s, voters established the Rainy Day Fund. It takes the oil and gas severance tax revenues above the 1988 year, and those dollars have been going in the Rainy Day Fund.
It's phenomenal what's going on. Texas has the opportunity to be energy independent, and with that brings an opportunity to solve some of our critical infrastructure needs. The Constitution Amendment of the 80s put the excess revenues into the Rainy Day Fund. The proposal today is to continue half of the dollars going in the Rainy Day Fund and to take the other half of those dollars and to target them to Fund 6, which is the Highway Transportation Fund and state government.
So this is a revenue stream that makes sense to go in the highway fund, and here's why. Did you know that the Rainy Day Fund or the Economic Stabilization Fund has a cap on it? There is a cap of about, I think the number is 10% of what the general revenue dollars happens to be from the previous biennium. And so in a few years, we're going to be hitting that cap anyway. And then the legislature would be spending those dollars from the general revenue fund. So if you're a conservative and you want to make certain that tax dollars are spent to where they need to be and not just spent on, you know, 1,000 different areas, you can make certain that those dollars are spent on roads. And I think that's a big selling point that people really need to consider, that those dollars will be going back to the general revenue fund pretty soon, as strong as our economy is.
238% increase in highway usage with a 19% increase in capacity. You drive that every day. You experience that and you understand it. These are the types of real hard tangible data that I think that we need to get out to the voters to make certain that they understand what kind of crisis that we're in. The legislature for 3 decades has taken money that has been in Fund 6 and they've appropriated those dollars for other purposes. Public safety is a very important function, but do we think we ought to be paying for it with highway dollars?
No.
I mean, the absolute answer to that is absolutely no.
So there's going to be competition for those dollars, but ending diversions has to be a priority if we're going to be a state that can continue to attract jobs and meet our basic infrastructure needs. Texas can be a leader that we need to be, and we can address our transportation crisis, but it's going to take leadership to do that. That's why I'm glad to be here and partnering with Move Texas Forward, that Scott is the executive director for. Move Texas Forward was started by a bipartisan group of former Texas Transportation Committee chairs, four different leaders that recognized we haven't been focused on where we need to go in addressing our transportation needs. They recognize this is a unique opportunity to make certain we win and we win big, so that the legislature understands transportation is important to Texas voters. Move Texas Forward is getting organized to do that. They're developing a multi-million dollar budget. There's no state resources spent on this constitutional amendment. It's all private dollars. There is going to be an opportunity, a very real opportunity for you to help set the agenda by being organized today.